Good Friday morning, Lincoln Lions. This is Mr. Conan. This is your daily announcements for Friday, May 22nd, 2020. Every day, we'll be doing the pledge, so please stand for the pledge. 3, 2, 1.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next, we head right into our Lincoln Spirit. Normally, we do this on Friday. We're doing it every day during closure, so let's do it on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Lincoln's spirit makes us proud, respectful lions above the crowd. Our spirit makes us try our best and challenges us to encourage the rest. Announcements. Students, today's your last day to turn in work. You can do so until 4 o'clock by putting it in the box out in front of the school. So please make sure you get all your work turned in today. Again, you have till 4 o'clock. June 4th, we have a reverse parade from 6 to 6:45 p.m. Drive by the front of the school with signs or just honk and wave. Say goodbye to your teachers and Mr. Conan. I'll be there too. Then on June 5th, we have a report card handout by your teachers. Another last time to see your teachers. Kindergarten, you're going to be going at 8 o'clock in the morning. First grade, 8:30. Second grade, 9. Third grade, 9:30. Fourth grade, 10 o'clock. And fifth grade, 10:30. Then lastly, we're going to celebrate our sixth graders by doing a honk and wave with them. That will be at June 5th at 12 o'clock. And teachers, we'll have a full staff meeting this Tuesday at 10:30. If things come up, we'll just cancel, but I think we'll stay with that time. If we change anything, it'll just be changing it to not have one, but I'll let you know. And of course, we moved it from today because today was packet pickup day. Thanks for being flexible. All right, talent show update. Yesterday at 4 o'clock was the due date for all of the talent show materials, all the stuff that you had to turn in. So hopefully you had turned in your video submission to our fantastic talent team, and they will be creating our talent show. All right, parenting tips, strategies, and self-care. Today's parenting tip comes from Mr. Conan with healthychildren.org. They discuss how to model. Now, in teaching, we know that modeling is one of the strongest instructional techniques that we can use. Same thing for a parent. You can discuss with your students how to model feelings. So talk through how you're managing your own feelings. Like, for example, I am worried about grandma since I can't go visit her, but the best I can do is to check in with her more often by phone. I'll put a reminder on my phone to call her in the morning and the afternoon until this outbreak ends. So great modeling. You can model the words and the language and match it to feelings too. So try using that tip with your children. All right, positive warrior. John Gordon, a well-known motivational speaker and author, talks about being positive, not because life is easy, but because life is hard. And I believe we must continue finding the positives, not only at home, but also outside the walls of our house. Today's positive warrior is Whitley. Believe it or not, it is Whitley's last day in Great Falls. She's moving this weekend. She has been a positive warrior in and out of school with her friends and family. And we wish her the best to her and her family. Her smile and her acts of kindness are appreciated, and we want her to go be a positive warrior. So please send me, your teacher, have your parents post on Facebook your positive warrior acts so we can continue to celebrate them on announcements each day. I believe this world needs more positives. Help me be a positive warrior. Book of the day. Each day we're going to be reading a story from you that has been from Scholastic Books that have been approved to read. Today I have a fabulous guest reader, one of our Lincoln Lions, Libby. She'll be reading the story, The Happy Dreamer by Peter Reynolds. At the very end of the story, we'll have some questions for you. So Libby, are you ready to share your book with us? Here we go.
Hi everyone, today I'm going to be reading The Happy Dreamer by Peter H. Reynolds. I'm a happy dreamer. I'm really good at dreaming. Daydreams, big dreams, little dreams, creative dreams. Can you imagine? Sometimes Willow tells me, sit still, be quiet, pay attention, focus. But my dreams have a mind of their own. Sometimes my mind just takes flight. I hear a beat, I gotta move. Then I hear another and another. Wish you could hear inside my head, trumpety zigzag jazz. Sometimes I am a quiet dreamer. When I make time to stay still, hear myself think to let and see what takes shape. Do you see that? Sometimes I'm a swing high dreamer. Way up high, beyond clouds, so high I can touch the sky. I can also be a loud dreamer, hello world, and a shout at the top of my lungs dreamer, even if it's just a loud inside my head dreamer. Sometimes I'm a colorful dreamer, painting my own path, full of surprises at every turn. I can dream even when the lights are out. All circuits on, fireworks. I light up all ears, eyes, hearts, and minds. I have so many dreams, it gets kind of messy. Creative chaos. Cleaning up hides my treasures. If you make me, I will put my things away. But then there is less me to show. These are the moments I feel alone, boxed in. And yet I always find a way back, plunging into amazing, delightful, happy dreams. I'm really good at being me, a dreamer, surprising, caring, funny, gentle, smart. And when I tremble back to earth, I know I'm okay. Dreamers have a way of bouncing back and moving forward. There's so many ways to be a happy dreamer. What kind of dreamer are you? But the best way to be a happy dreamer is just to be you, which is why this book is dedicated to you. Yes, you. Hope you guys like the book, Happy Dreamer.
Thanks, Libby. What a great book. So she has a question in there for you. What kind of a dreamer are you? So think about that for a little bit. What kind of a dreamer are you? Yeah, please talk to a sibling or a mom or a dad or anyone in the house that you could discuss that with. What a great book that has positivity in it. So we're looking for just a couple more people to read books in the morning. We only have about 9 school days left, and I think I have 4 or 5 people lined up to read. So just need a couple more to finish out the year. All right, song of the day. Each day we're bringing you a motivational song to get you ready for remote learning. If you'd like to nominate a song for morning announcements, please email me or talk with your teacher or have your parents write a comment on this Facebook post. Today's song comes from Whitley. She wanted everyone to take on the world. So listen to Rowan Blanchard and Sabrina Carpenter's song, Take on the World. Go be a positive warrior and go Lion Pride.
For a day like this to come struck like lightning, my heart's beating like a drum on the edge of something wonderful. Face to face with changes, what's it all about? Life is crazy, but I know I can work it out, cause I got you to live it with me. Take on the world, take on the world, take on the world, take on the world. was okay.